well-regarded New York Post columnist, veteran columnist, Kevin Kernan, joins us here on Big Board Sports with John Carlos Stanton being introduced at 2 o'clock this afternoon in Lake Buena Vista, Florida. Amazing that Brian Cashman pulled this one off. Did not think it would happen on Friday, but by Saturday morning, it was pretty much done. And we welcome Mr. Kernan to our show here on Big Board Sports. Roger Weil and Kevin, good morning. Thanks for a few minutes.
Hey, Roger, how you doing?
I'm good. Thank you. Appreciate it. I know you're not at the winter baseball meetings, but I know you're ready to write columns and figure out what kind of a fit Stanton is going to be. And what a signing by Brian Cashman. Are you surprised that he was able to pull this off?
No, I wasn't really. And to back that up, last week, about Thursday or so, one of my bosses called and said, hey, why don't you do a winter meetings column going into Sunday? And I've been doing a lot of the Giants stuff, too, as well, and Jets. Been kind of crazy times in New York here. And then, usually they went that Sunday column in earlier, and I said, well, why don't we wait until Friday? I knew I had to go to the Giants. So I said, why don't we wait until Saturday morning, because this Stanton stuff is going on, and I would not be shocked if the Yankees wound up with him, simply because it made the most sense, because really, the Marlins and Jeter kind of misplayed their hand right from the start. In some ways, this is like the NBA, and LeBron called his shot. The superstars that have no trade in their contract can call the shot. So it made perfect sense. The Dodgers weren't going to go in this direction, I didn't think. And, there was talk maybe the Cubs or Astros, but that, Astros aren't going to spend that money. And the Cubs have a little bit of a log jam, so it made perfect sense. The Yankees were moving from a position of power and basically got them pretty cheap.
Yeah, I mean, and a deal that Derek Jeter is being highly criticized for in Miami, Kevin.
Yeah, and he should be, simply because of the way he went about it. His first call has got to be to Stanton. He's got to sit down with Stanton and figure out where you want to go, and then go from there. He didn't do that, but the real problem lies with the previous administration ownership. How in the world do you give Stanton that contract plus a complete no trade for playing for the Marlins? You just tell him it's either this or one or the other. If you don't like it, go somewhere else. But there's so many inept organizations in baseball across the board. Even a little small example, even the Astros, everybody talks about the Verlander trade. Well, it was the players who really pushed for that trade, not the GM. He didn't really want to get involved trading some of his talent. So, I think the Yankees really have a clear shot for a dynasty right now, to be quite frank, if they get to pick up a pitcher or two. Because nobody in baseball, a lot of these teams don't even try anymore, Roger. It's really that simple, to be quite blunt. And one stat I want to throw at you, this is probably a million stats, but here's one you probably haven't heard. Sanchez, Aaron Judge, and Stanton combined for like 144 homers last year. That's more than the San Francisco Giants hit as a team, and it's not too far behind what the Red Sox hit as a team, which I think was in that 160. 66, 68 range. So this is incredible power. It's getting Stanton in Yankee Stadium. He'll check swing and get home run to the right field.
There's no doubt.
It's going to be interesting.
Kevin, the expectations were not so high last year, right? It was like, the Yankees will gear up for 2018 and see what they can do. And then they're a win away from the World Series last year. Now Aaron Boone comes in. Now you add Stanton to this lineup next to Aaron Judge, Gary Sanchez, Didi. It's a glorified all-star team all of a sudden, and you mentioned the word dynasty. I mean, anything short of getting the World Series next season, Kevin, is going to be a disappointment or really a failure with this lineup that they're going to throw out in the field.
Well, especially since they should have been in a World Series this year, but Roger, you know me pretty well, and I call it like it is, and the Yankees really should have won the World Series this year, in my mind. They had just the worst base running you could imagine, who a player I love, Greg Bird, but he got caught flat-footed, getting thrown out of home in that Astros game. And, if not, they beat the Astros in my mind, and they easily beat the Dodgers. I just think they were that good. So, yeah, the pressure's going to be on the new manager, Aaron Boone. But he's a chill Southern California guy. He'll deal with it. He'll be a better manager, I think, than Girardi was. And, you know, you never know with baseball. Injuries always are the key. And Stanton certainly has an injury history. But the Yankees seem to be, you know, if you're a Yankee fan, you got to be feeling pretty good going into this. Into the winter meetings, not even going into the season.
Judge and Stanton combined for 111 home runs last year, and now they're going to be side by each. How about this one, though, Kevin? You've been around the New York scene forever. How about players reacting to New York, all right? This is not going to be the Marlins. This is going to be a little different with the media attention and everything that goes along with that. How do you think he'll fit in the New York scene? Can he embrace the New York scene?
He's going to have to change. I wrote a little bit about this in the Sunday paper. The Yankees are now officially back to being the evil empire, and there are some pitfalls with this trade, and one of them is Stanton himself. He could be a pain in the neck. You know, I had to deal with this guy a number of times, and he's always standoffish, always defensive. He comes into New York late last year. I remember a Mets series, and, you know, the natural stories was to talk about him and Judge, and he blew off the media for a day or so. He finally broke, you know, I don't even know if he talked about it. He was supposed to be the ambassador during the All-Star game and couldn't handle those questions well, too, about Judge. So he's going to have to mature in that respect. Everybody says he's a good, you know, his people say he's a good person, he's a good guy, but he's highly defensive when it comes to the media. The media will be there every day. If you're a Yankee, and the Yankees do a good job with the media, in one respect, the players are accountable for the most part and at their locker. Unlike the New York Football Giants, by the way, just a little aside since I was there last night. You know, so the Yankees, I think the Yankees will put him through a tutorial on how to deal with the media, and we'll see how he handles it.
Kevin Kernan, always a pleasure. Thanks for a few minutes. New York Post columnist, longtime columnist, well-regarded, Kev. We appreciate a few minutes, as always, here on Big Board Sports 104.5, a team, ESPN Radio in Albany.
Okay, Roger. Take care.